गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, साई राम। टुडे वी विल डू पार्ट टू ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 4, रिटायरमेंट ऑफ ए पार्टनर। टुडे वी विल डू कैलकुलेशन ऑफ अमाउंट ड्यू टू रिटायरिंग पार्टनर। इट मीन्स हाउ एट द टाइम ऑफ रिटायरमेंट ऑफ ए पार्टनर हाउ मच अमाउंट वी विल गिव, हाउ मच अमाउंट वी विल पे टू द रिटायरिंग पार्टनर। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट द क्वेश्चन। एम एन एंड जी वर पार्टनर्स इन ए फर्म शेयरिंग प्रॉफिट एंड लॉसेस इन द रेशियो ऑफ 5:3:2। ऑन 31st March 2016 देयर बैलेंस शीट वॉज एन अंडर। Now her balance sheet is given here in liability and asset side, both sides are given. So we will start the adjustment. M retired on the above date and it was agreed that debtors of ₹2,000 will be written off as bad debt and provision of 5% on debtors for bad and doubtful debt will be maintained. Second adjustment is patent will be completely written off and stock, machinery and building will be depreciated by 5%. Third is an unrecorded creditor of ₹10,000 will be taken into account. Fourth is N and G will share the future profit in the ratio of 2:3. Fifth one, goodwill of the firm on M's retirement was valued at ₹3 lakh. Pass necessary journal entries for the above transaction in the books of the firm on M's retirement. Children, in this question, you have to pass the journal entries. Only journal entries you have to give. But before giving the journal entries, you have to make revaluation account and partner's capital account. Okay, so in this question, three partners M, N and G, their all ratio is 5:3:2 and the closing date of balance sheet is 31st March 2016. These are the adjustments and the new ratio of remaining partners N and G is given 2:3. So first we have to make revaluation account. So in revaluation account, what you have to do? You know the format of revaluation account. This you have already learned in admission of a partner and in this chapter also. Revaluation account in debit side, see this is the debit side and this is the credit side. In this debit side, you have to show decrease in asset, increase in liability and unrecorded liability. This will come two side, and by side, increase in asset, decrease in liability and unrecorded asset. These three will come credit side. Okay. Now we will start making the revaluation account. So the first adjustment is debtor of ₹2,000 will be written off as bad debt and provision of 5% on debtor for bad and doubtful debt will be maintained. Children, here look at the debtor amount. Here debtor amount is given. Children, you have to cut this amount. This is 45,000. This is 45,000 less 5,000 provision. Then the remaining debtor amount is 40,000. Okay. Now the adjustment is given. 2,000 will be written off as bad debt and provision 5% required on debtors. So debtor amount is 45,000. Now in this 45,000, out of this 45,000, 2,000 is the bad debt amount. This is given in the adjustment. So this you have to subtract. Now remaining amount is 43,000. Now in this 43,000, you have to charge 5%. So 5% you have to charge. So it is equal to 2150. This is the provision amount 2150. Okay, children, up to here clear? Debtor is 45,000. Subtract this 2,000. This 2,000 bad debt, new bad debt amount, and the remaining debtor on the remaining debtor you have to charge 5%. So 5% is 2150. Okay. Now what you have to do? See, the old provision. The old provision amount is 5,000. Okay, and the new provision is. New bad debt is 2,000. This is the new bad debt. This you have to subtract. And the new provision amount is 2150. This you have to subtract. Now what is remaining? The remaining amount, it will come in the revaluation account. Okay. This remaining amount you have to write down in the revaluation account. See. In the revaluation account, you have to write down the 850. It means 850, you have to write down here. Decrease in liability. Okay? Decrease in liability. Why decrease in liability? Because 5,000 is old provision. It means in previous year, the provision amount is 5,000. And in current year, the provision amount is 2,000 bad debt and 2150 new provision. So it is 4150. It means old provision is 5,000, new provision is 4150. It is decreased by 850. So you have to show in the decrease side, means credit side. Okay. Next is patent will be completely written off. Return off means completely decreased. So you have to write down patent. Patent is an asset. So patent, write down two side. Here you have to write down patent. Completely written off means completely decreased amount. Now stock, machinery and building. These three items depreciated by 5%. So depreciated means decreased. So these three items you have to write down debit side. Now amount 5% you have to calculate and write down the amount. Now 5% on the balance sheet. Look at the balance sheet. Stock, machinery and building. Patent 30,000 amount we have written. Okay. Now stock amount is 50,000. So on 50,000, 5% you have to calculate. So 5% amount on this 50,000. 2500. So stock is depreciated by 2500. Same calculation for machinery. Machinery amount is 150,000. Now calculate 5%. So the amount you have to write down 7500 in the machinery and building 1 lakh. So on 1 lakh also you have to find out 5%. So it is 5,000. So all these three amount you have to write down here. To stock 2500. Machinery 7500 and building 5,000. Now next is unrecorded creditor of rupees 10,000 will be taken into account. Here unrecorded creditor. Creditor means liability. So unrecorded liability, where you have to write down two sides. So two creditor 10,000 you have to take. Okay. Now NMG future profit is given, goodwill of the firm. So this will not come in the revaluation account. Now total, do the total of revaluation account. Here debit side is greater, credit side is smaller. So debit side total is 55,000, subtract with the 850 and answer profit is 54,150, which you have to divide in the old ratio, that is 5-3-2. In this ratio, you have to divide the loss amount. Okay. So, M and G having loss, loss amount you have to distribute among in this ratio. Okay children, this is the revaluation account. In this only debtor, provision for debtor calculation is tough. So I already told. Now next is partners capital account. In partners capital account, firstly you have to transfer the capital balances. The first thing, you have to transfer the capital balances of all three partners. Next thing is the general reserve. This general reserve you have to distribute in this old ratio in partners capital account. Okay, which side? Buy side. These things you have to distribute buy side or credit side. Okay, now in asset side, here profit and loss account is there. So profit and loss account you have to distribute in this old ratio, in this old ratio two side, or you can say debit side. Okay, so see this partners capital account. First buy balance brought down. By balance brought down. After that, by balance brought down. After that, general reserve you have to distribute in old ratio. This is the old ratio, and general reserve is given in balance sheet liability side. Next is profit and loss given asset side of the balance sheet. So that profit and loss you have to distribute in 5-3-2 ratio. Okay, and revaluation loss, this you have already distributed in the old ratio, so transfer it here. Okay, now the next is come to the goodwill calculation. Now come to the goodwill calculation. Here goodwill of the firm is given 3 lakh. Okay, and who is retiring here? AMS. So children, 3 lakh is the goodwill amount, and who is retiring? AM. So AM share is 5/10, it means 1,50,000. So this is the AM share of goodwill. Now this goodwill you have to distribute in the gaining ratio. And what is the gaining ratio formula? New ratio minus old ratio. And children, in this question, new ratio is given 2:3 and old ratio is given 5:3:2. In this you have to remove the M. 5 you have to remove. So the ratio of NNG is 2:3 new ratio and old ratio 3:2. Find out the gaining ratio. New ratio minus old ratio, find out the gaining ratio. This you already know how to find out gaining ratio. And after finding the gaining ratio, you have to distribute 1,50,000 in gaining ratio. Okay, so in gaining ratio 1,50,000 you have to distribute in the, and the gaining ratio is 1:2. So 1/3 and 2/3. 1:2. Gaining ratio is, I think, 1:4. 30,000 and 1,50,000 into 4/5, 1,20,000. So now the N and G share of goodwill is 30,000 and 1,20,000. Now how you have to transfer the goodwill? You have to transfer the goodwill. First you have to make journal entry, or you can directly write down. Buy side you have to write down N's capital account, G's capital account, remaining partner's capital account, and the amount of goodwill you have to write down in the M's account, M's column. Remaining amount you have to, remaining partner's goodwill amount you have to transfer. By N's capital account, by G's capital account, and amount you have to write down in the M's column. एंड टू साइड यू हैव टू राइट डाउन टू एम्स कैपिटल अकाउंट एंड अमाउंट यू हैव टू राइट डाउन इन दी एन एन जे कॉलम 30,000 एंड 1,20,000. ओके नाउ आफ्टर दिस यू हैव टू डू द टोटल एंड फाइंड आउट द बैलेंस सी डी. सो चिल्ड्रन हेयर एम इज रिटायरिंग पार्टनर. वेन यू विल डू द टोटल ऑफ एम इट इज इक्वल टू 3,15,000 सब्ट्रैक्ट विद दिस अमाउंट सो द बैलेंस इज 2,75,425. दिस इज द एम्स लोन अमाउंट. वाई लोन? बिकॉज नाउ एम इज रिटायरिंग सो नो मोर बैलेंस ऑफ एम इज रिमेनिंग. नाउ दिस अमाउंट यू हैव टू ट्रांसफर इन द एम्स लोन अकाउंट. दिस इज द ड्यू अमाउंट ऑफ एम. यू हैव टू गिव टू द एम 2,75,425. ओके सो दिस इज द एम्स लोन अकाउंट. दिस अमाउंट यू हैव टू ट्रांसफर इन द एम्स लोन अकाउंट रिटायरिंग पार्टनर लोन अकाउंट. And remaining partner NNG, you have to find out the balance CD. Same balance CD you have to find out. Okay? So children, this is the partner's capital account. Now after this, you have to make the journal entry. Now how you have to make the journal entry? See, look at this revaluation account. Look at this revaluation account. In this, by provision for doubtful debt is written by side and two side patent stock machinery building creditors are written. So you can make general entry in this way: revaluation account debit, revaluation account debit to patent account, revaluation account debit to stock account. This is the separate entry. If you want, you can make the combined entry in this way: revaluation account debit to patent account, to stock account, to machinery account, to building account. All asset you can take in one entry. This is the combined entry or compound entry. Okay? Now next entry is revaluation account debit to creditor account 10,000. Now in provision for doubtful debt, what you have to give? You have to give the general entry. But here bad debt is also, so you have to make that entry of bad debt also. Now journal entry, look at this journal entry children: bad debt account debit to debtor. Debtor against bad debt amount is given 2,000. So first entry you have to write down: bad debt account debit to debtor 2,000. And the second entry, that bad debt amount, that bad debt amount you have to transfer in the provision. So the journal entry for this provision for doubtful debt account debit to bad debt 2,000. And the last, the 850 is the balance. 850 is the actual bad debt. So you have to write down provision for doubtful debt account debit to revaluation account. Here provision is written by side. So provision for doubtful debt account debit to revaluation account 850. Okay, and after that other entry you have to make in the similar way which I have told: revaluation account debit to patent, to stock, to machinery, to building. All assets you have to write down in one entry. Next is revaluation to creditor. Next entry, transfer of loss. So M's capital account debit, N's capital account debit, G's capital account debit to revaluation. Okay, and next entry from the capital account, general reserve. You have transfer the general reserve. So the entry general reserve is transferred credit side. So entry will be general reserve account debit to M's capital account, to N's capital account, to G's capital account. Okay, next is profit and loss you have transferred in two side. So entry will be M's capital account debit, N's capital account debit, G's capital account debit to P&L account, and amount you have to write down according to the distribution. Okay, next entry for distribution of goodwill amount. So goodwill calculation you have already done, gaining ratio you have already find out, and the entry you have to write down: N's capital account debit G's capital account debit to M's capital. The entry is gaining partner's capital account debit, gaining partner's capital account debit to retiring partner. This is the distribution of goodwill entry. And the at last, at the end, you have to make one entry that is for due amount of M. M is a retiring partner, so the entry is M's capital account debit to M's loan account. In this, you have to transfer the due amount of M. Okay, children? In this way, you have to do this question. If in the question, if in the question is given, you have to pass journal entry. So, you have to make revaluation account and partner's capital account in the working note. And journal entry, you have to show clearly. Okay, this is the question. If you have to make only revaluation account, partner's capital account and balance sheet, then all these three accounts you have to do in fair clearly. Okay, otherwise if journal entry is there, then journal entry you have to do in clearly, and revaluation account and capital account you can make in rough side also. Okay, so children, now after this question, your topic is completed and your chapter is also completed. I want to say one thing, that is in this chapter two portion has been deleted from the CBSE. First is retirement of a partner, adjustment of in retirement of a partner, adjustment of capital account. Adjustment of capital account has been deleted. And the second topic is amount due of deceased partner or his executive account. These two topics has been deleted from the CBSE. Okay, so the topic we have covered in this chapter all are completed. Now in chapter number 3 also one topic is deleted, that is adjustment of capital in admission of a partner. So I have made one video for that topic, adjustment of capital, in presentation 7 of chapter 3, admission of a partner. So if you want, you can study. If not, so no need to see. Okay, that topic has been deleted from the course. Okay, now do practice and do prepare all these topics. Thank you. Sayonara.